All right, guys, this is part two of the Ace V3 chip on installed on the Trinity motherboard. It's actually a it's a Halo console. But anyway, I have my my J Runner. Okay, J Runner open on a TV. Now we're gonna push it to the console. It's a little dark here, guys, so you gotta bear with me. So you have to install, put power on. Okay, you gotta connect your NAND wires. As you can see, right there. All right, power's on, but don't turn it on. So, now see that lit up? All right, so I already did my create ECC. I already created write ECC to the thing. It's already here. It's already on my, it's already in here. It's already done. So now I gotta boot that up, which I'm gonna do that in a few minutes. Here's, I'm gonna show you where the timing file. You go into custom, press XFVS, and you're gonna look for it on your computer. So mine is the files that I have on my documents. So Ace timing files, you're gonna go into the Trinity, 300 megahertz. Then you're gonna go in the 60.3 file, and you're gonna do the TRL 0.6T63 files, this one. What you have to do when you program the chip is just hit run, which is, I made a, I have another, with the little pointy tips, if you could see. You insert those in the hole. All right, so now I'm gonna hook up. The motherboard to my monitor. Now I'm gonna have to turn it on. I have to get a front plate to see. See if it boots up. Okay, guys, as you see the chip, it's right there. Motherboard is connected to my HDMI cable in the back, and so what I'm gonna do is turn it on. You could turn it on without the turner button, so it's right here actually. See, now we see glitching. Let's see. There you go. Let's see Come on, baby. I'm gonna have to change that timing file to a different. Well, if it doesn't boot up, I'm gonna have to change that timing file. Like I explained, I have to stick it in the little holes there and reprogram the chip. Which doesn't look like this is a good boot. There you go. Wow, it took quite a bit. It actually booted. But I don't like that file. So now it's reading Zales. That's the most important thing. I'm just turning around to my monitor where Zelle is. So as you can see, Zelle is reading the files. It did take quite a bit longer than I thought. But all right, guys, here's your CPU and DVD key right there. So I don't have this hooked up to the internet, so I'm gonna have to manually write it down right now, which is to what we're gonna do to install the key. All right, let me write this down. CPU key. Eight three seven D F three B seven D seven F three C eight nine six eight nine six six zero eight nine six zero eight zero zero one letter A zero two B C one two B three four. All right, so I got Zealous and I got the CPU key and the DVD key. So I'm gonna type Lee manually into JRunner. I'm gonna install it, put it into JRunner. So let's shut the console off, which I'm gonna do that now. Console's off. I like to do is disconnect the power completely right now. After you do that, clear the system. Disconnect HDMI. So now we're gonna go into exit this off. Gonna go into CPU key, type that in. You have to type it manually, so what you gotta do is just type it, that's all. If I can get it to type, what the hell's my wrong with my keyboard? Okay, eight, there you go. always don't mix up. I just press the O, but it's a zero. It could be an O, but I don't know. But it could be a then zero. If you press the wrong number, wrong letter, it won't do nothing. So you just have to go back and retype things that look like double letters or whatever. You gotta be precise. Less number, guys. There you go, let's see. There you go. All right, so it was the right key. So everything did itself, as you can see. Wrote down the DVD key, no bad blocks, info, KV info, everything is right there. Trinity motherboard, 17489. Okay, Trinity NAND and enlarged, finished moving, else. Okay, all right, so this is all done. All right, so now what you got to do is you're going to create XE build, which is, that's the upflash folder that you're going to have to, so you're going to press create XE build. It's creating its XE build upflash folder. All right, so it's finished. So that is done already. It's already in here. All right, now you're gonna go back to your console. Okay, you're gonna go back to your console. You're gonna connect the power back on the back side. Power back on, connect your NAND, your JR programmer. Into your console. Guys, don't turn it on. Whatever you do, don't turn it on at all. So now it's all ready. Okay, so JR program is connected. Power's connected. Let's go back to the monitor. All right, so now what you gotta do is press right NAND. Wrong version. Aha! What the hell's going on? All right. Let's see. Maybe I have to disconnect everything. Turn it back on. Okay. All right. Let's try again. What you have to do is disconnect your JRunner from the PC, which I didn't. That's what it meant. That's why it said wrong version, because it's one thing you have to do all the time. It's every time you do certain things, like moving from Zealous to write something, got to disconnect everything. So I never really disconnected the JRunner from my PC. So that's why it happened. It gave me the wrong version. But now it's writing its files, and I'll boot it up in a few seconds. It'll go right into a dashboard. So just sit tight. Let it run its files. Write its NAND. It is a pretty long file. It'll take a couple of minutes. I do have a Nandex, but the Nandex is quicker, but I don't think it's running too right. I have to, but JRun is doing its job. It does a nice job. I like JRun. It's a little slower. All right, so guys, this is pretty much the installation. I just didn't do the video how to read the NAND, which is very simple. You could pull that up anywhere you want. The NAND is very important to have two nice NANDs and make sure you save them. Because anything could happen. If you don't have those NANDs, forget it. That console is garbage. So, literally used for parts. That's about it. But anyway, let's see how this baby's going to boot up. It took a little longer than I thought. I might have to change those timing files. Go to a different one. I'm going to have to go to a different, higher one, a quicker one. Might boot it up first, faster. For now, I'm going to leave it the way it is for now. See what happens. Alright, it took 3 minutes and 37 seconds. Not bad at all. See the up flash bin? Now, alright, I'm going to show you where all this stuff is. You go open up a show working folder. This is it. This is all the up flash that I uploaded. The NANDs, KV info, image, CPU key, and the DVD, all the DVD keys right here. Everything is in, which is the show working folder, which is on, supposed to be on your JRana. When you get the JRana system, it's supposed to be in the output folder. So it's right here. Here's a console right here. That's all the info. That's it. Trinity, that's right there. And this is nothing. That's just a, this is the console number right here, the serial number. That's everything right there. All right? Okay, guys. Now, I'm going to boot this up. What you got to do is disconnect. Disconnect the JRunner. All right, disconnect the power for a few seconds. Always, that's what I gotta do. You gotta disconnect everything and shut off, take everything off. Now we're gonna put HDMI cable back on. Power back on. As you can see, my ACE chip turned on. Let me connect my remote. So when I to the front, my USB. Okay. All right. Let's boot this baby. Let's boot this baby out. All right, guys. Let's keep fingers crossed. Thing is on. There you go, guys. Ooh, this thing booted like a rocket. Holy shit. F me, man. Holy crap. There you go, guys. Holy shit. That was quick. I didn't know that. Fucker. All right, guys. Look. Let me show you the dash. Up. serial number is right there, see it? -17489. That's exactly what I have on the thing. All right, so now all I got to do is let me boot it up again. I'm going to shut this off. And I'm going to boot it up, see how fast it boots up. Let's see. Fans shutting off. We're going to boot it up again, guys. All right, this thing is off. Fans off. Everything's off. Let me press the button on the remote. Let's see. I guess it's paratus. It boots up certain times faster than others. The other one is an instant boot. This is taking a little bit longer. I gotta time this shit. Man, this thing is, I gotta change that timing file. I don't like that timing file. Sporadus freaking takes too long, or it takes, there you go. It took quite a bit, man. I don't like it. I do not like it. Let me shut it off again. Shut it off again. Let me do the clock. I want to time that. I want to see how long it takes. I gotta change this file. I gotta play with another file on it. On the, there you go. 26 seconds. Not bad, huh? Not bad. I'll dig it. I'll dig that. 26 seconds. All right. Let me try another one more time. Reset. Let me use a controller this time to turn it on. Wait till that stops completely. There you go. Controller on. Lights on. Start time. I'll boot it another one more time just to kind of see where I'm at. Yeah, this will be for sale. It's a Halo. The nice Halo custom gray one, slim. It's already almost a minute. I should play with a different file. Wow, man. This is taking a while. There you go. It took a minute and 20 seconds. It's still not bad at all. Still not bad. Still not my favorite, but... Shut it off again. Reset the clock again. I want to disconnect the power for a minute just to see. Reset the chip, see what happens. Put the power back on. All right, let's do it again. Let's connect it again. Power's on. No, it's not. Power's on. Start time. Ah, man. Chip is glitching. Good glitch. There you go. Holy shit, man. This was less than 10 seconds. All right, I guess I'll keep this for now. But anyway, guys, this will be for sale. I'll have it, like, with my other Corona that I just put up a video before of it. They'll be up for sale. They'll be on eBay. Once I get done, I'll give this one a 250 gigabyte hard drive with all the whistles. You name it, guys. So, all right? All right, thanks, guys, for watching my video. And don't forget to subscribe and be a fan of 360 modding hobbies. All right, guys, see ya.